Dr. K. S. Ramakrishnan is working as an assistant professor, School of Education, Tamil Nadu Open University, Chennai 15. He has been teaching science education, environmental science, educational technology, and research methodology in various colleges of education and Tamil Nadu Open University for the past 9 years. He has guided so many M.Ed., M.Phil., and Ph.D. students. His current research areas are environmental education, educational technology, and media and communication. He has conducted various workshops on ICT usage in education, Wiki Educator, e-content development, and educational research methodology. He had attended many online workshops on Moodle, learning analytics. He has published 6 books and many articles in national and international journals of repute. He regularly gives plenary and keynote speeches on environment and ICT-related issues at various national and international conferences. He has delivered 28 episodes of the program Pudiyodor Ulagam at All India Radio, Chennai, related to various new developments in science and technology.
Dear audience, welcome to UGC's CSE program. In this episode of Environmental Science, we will discuss about the land degradation and desertification. And so, the content we are going to discuss, the factors affecting desertification, the effects of drought, overgrazing, overcultivation and cutting of trees, soil erosion and wind erosion, the impact of human activity on soil erosion, and some steps to avoid desertification. So, these are all the major topics that we are going to discuss today. See, as per the Penguin Dictionary of Physical Geography 2000, the desertification is defined as the extension of typical desert landscape, landforms, and processes to areas where they did not occur in the recent past. Such changes take place in arid zones bordering the deserts, in areas which experience the average annual rainfall of 100 to 300 millimeter. That means the definition says that whatever the unnatural activities which are happening in the near desert areas where the average rainfall, that is from 100 to 300 millimeter, and therefore simply speaking, the conversion of the agricultural land or the ecosystem into the desert ecosystem, that particular process is called desertification. And now, what are the factors affecting the desertification? There are 4 main factors which are corresponding for desertification, and the first one is drought. That means the drought and famine, the loss of water, and that is causing a havoc on the ecosystem, and so it is leading to desert. And the second factor, that is overgrazing. See, for example, every land, the grassland or wetland, they can sustain up to a particular number of animals only. In case if the animals are grazing over and over again on the same land, then what will happen? The amount of grass will go on reducing, and so that is affecting the rainfall, and so gradually what will happen in a long time, that particular area, the grassland, will be converted into desert. And therefore, the overgrazing, that is one of the most important factor for the desertification. And the third one, overcultivation. So, it is on the other side. See, for example, again and again, people are cultivating the land, because the agricultural land that need some rest also. That means we have to keep that land fallow. In case if again and again over cultivation, that means in an year 3 times, 4 times, etc., then what will happen? The land will become saline or acidic also, and so that over cultivation, that is also a cause for the desertification, because the land will become saline. And the last one, the trees used for fuel and shelter. Because even though it is taken in small quantities, gradually what will happen, that has to be replenished. That has to be replenished back. But sometimes what will happen, only that we are taking out, but nothing is repaid or replenished, then what will happen? Gradually the amount of vegetation, it will go on reducing, leading to the desertification. And so these are all the four factors: the drought and the overgrazing, the over cultivation, and the trees used for the fuel and the shelter. So these are all the four major factors affecting the desertification. Now the contribution of factors. So here it is desertification. One major factor is the climate, and the other the human activities, and third the animal activities. The grazing, that will come under animal activity. The over cultivation, that will come under human activity. And the rest, they are the climate factors. And so these are all the factors which are affecting the desertification. And now let us discuss in detail what are the characteristics of desertification. See, in two ways that it will happen. One is the human side and another is the animal side. See, the first of all, when the population is increasing, what will happen? And they start deforesting for firewood. And so that will lead to the roots no longer hold soil together, because the roots, they are keeping the soil together, because they are binding the soil. In case if the roots are not there, there is no binding force for keeping the soil together, and therefore what will happen? The roots are no longer holding the soil together, and the leaves are no longer protect the soil from weather. Because the soil, the leaves are protecting the soil, they provide the shade and they reduce the temperature. And if there is no leaf, what will happen? The sunlight will directly fall on the soil, and therefore there is no protection for the soil. And because of all the factor, and one more factor, the loose topsoil is blown away by wind. So again that I'll tell, see, when the population is increasing, it will lead to deforestation, and it will lead to the loss of roots, and therefore there is no binding force, and there is no leaves, and therefore there is no protection for the soil. And all these factors, totally what will happen? The loose topsoil, that is blown away by the wind. And so because of the human beings, the land is gradually becoming a desert. And now the second factor, that is coming from the animal side, and the increase in cattle. When the human beings are increasing in number, automatically the cattle number also will increase, and therefore the grassland is grazed more intensively, and that is leading to the roots may be eaten as well as grass, because the animals are eating the grass as well as the roots also. And less vegetation means less protection from weather, and therefore the loose topsoil is blown away by the wind. See, the steps are more or less same, but only it is caused by the animals. And therefore by these two ways, the land will become a desert in due course. Now let us see the factors one by one. First let us take the drought. And what is the meaning of drought? A long period without rainfall. For a long time, if there is no rainfall, then that will lead to drought. And it causes the crops to die and lack of food, and may have to move to find food, because the human beings and animals, they have to move to various places in search of food and water. And therefore, what will happen? In totality, the land will become barren. And you look at the diagram, see how that is, what is the condition of the land. There is no vegetation, there is no root, and therefore what will happen? The temperature, because all this area, and the temperature will increase drastically, and therefore even the top soil, that is broken into fragments, and therefore it is the net result of the drought. And then comes the effect of overgrazing, already that we have discussed. And when too many animals are grazing on the land, and the animals eat all the vegetation, and the vegetation fails to grow because the amount of grass eaten by the animals, that has to be replenished back. But it may not happen because so many animals are eating the grass, and therefore the vegetation fails to grow, and the soil is exposed to rain and wind, and the soil is washed away or blown away. So in either way, because of the wind also, because when the vegetation is there, the wind, if the wind is blowing, the roots and the stem, they will protect the soil. If there is nothing, then automatically what will happen? The erosion is happening because of two factors. One is the water and another is the air, and therefore by both ways the topsoil is taken away or blown away. See, now look at the diagram. On one side of the diagram, it is somewhat barren land. That means that already the desertification has started. And on the other side, the cattle, they are grazing the land. See, you look at the diagram, there is no cattle over here because already that grass has been eaten away. But here there is some amount of grass, and therefore all the animals are populated here. And therefore, if the current trends continue, what will happen? So let us see what actually what will happen. See, this is the net result, and actually this one, that is becoming a desert, and this one, so all the animals and all, they will start dying, and there is nothing to eat, and therefore gradually what will happen? The previous diagram, so this kind of a diagram will become this kind of land, and ultimately that will become this one, and that is what we are calling as a desert. Now the example of overgrazing, you look at the diagram, here only one small bush is there, and how many number of goats, and therefore it is the example for overgrazing. See, in states like Gujarat, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra, the overgrazing is one of the major reasons for land degradation. And even for the desert, which is in Rajasthan, the reason was same. Once upon a time, it was a thick green forest. And because of the overgrazing, actually, the foreigners, the invaders, they came here and they have taken away all the lions. And therefore, the predator for the goats or the animal population, that is less, and therefore these animals, they have started overgrazing the forest area. So gradually what happened, the forest had become a desert, and that is the way the Rajasthan desert was made. And now let us see the other factor, that is over cultivation. Many crops being grown on the land year after year. That means every year without non-stop that people are growing the crops, and there is no rotation of crops. It's very important because the land, when it is producing a particular crop, it has lost some kind of minerals, and therefore what will happen in the next time, another crop should be grown in the same area, and therefore what will happen, whatever minerals lost because of the first crop, and they can be replenished by the second crop, and therefore the ecosystem, the land balance will be maintained. And every year, year after year, if the same crop is being grown, then what will happen? There is no rotation of crops, and so the crops will take all the nutrients from the soil, and the soil becomes infertile and nothing can grow, and there are no crops to protect the soil, and ultimately the last line, the soil again easily eroded by wind and rain. The last line, that is same for all the process, only the processes are somewhat different. Now let us have a short break. Welcome back from the break. Let us continue. Now an example for over irrigation. See this land, because year after year that it is cultivated, and therefore after some time it will become saline. In Punjab, Haryana, Western Uttar Pradesh, over irrigation is responsible for land degradation and water logging. Because you look at the diagram, the water logging that will lead to the increase in salinity and alkalinity in the soil, and therefore what will happen, the soil will become infertile. And the next factor, the removal of trees, and there are few trees in the desert and their roots hold the soil together. And when the trees are removed for firewood or to build a shelter, the roots die and the soil becomes loose. And yet again, this means the soil can be easily blown or washed away. So in this way also, the topsoil is blown or washed away. See, look at the diagram, the green bush, and that has become a barren land or semi-desert. And see, that is when these trees, they are taken one by one, and the roots are also lost, and therefore there is nothing to bind the soil together. And so when the air that is passing through, that will take all the soil, and so the land will become a desert. Now the soil erosion, it goes hand in hand with the desertification, and the soil erosion occur due to water sheets and gullies, wind and human activities. See, the water sheet means, because the soil, the top soil, when the water is flowing at a particular place, that is called the water sheets. And gully means some small canals of water, and they are the gullies, and wind and human activities. So all these are corresponding for the soil erosion. And the desertification occur where soil erosion and rainfall is a variable. And so naturally they are leading to desertification. And how shall we tackle the soil erosion? The soil erosion happens if heavy rainfall after a drought result in soil erosion. See, for example, there's a drought in a particular area, and after a certain time, then heavy rainfall happens, then what will happen? That will result in the soil erosion. Because for a long time, there was no vegetation or less vegetation, and therefore the top soil that is almost free, and so when heavy rain is falling, then what will happen, the top soil that is totally taken away or removed, and therefore it will lead to severe soil erosion. And if ground has structures to reduce runoff, then the erosion is less damaging. In case if there are any structure, natural or artificial, then the soil erosion may be somewhat less, and otherwise what will happen, the damage will be severe. And there are two main routes in which that we can avoid the soil erosion. And the first one, the perennial plants. Perennial means forever. So these plants, the perennial plants, if you are growing and growing the trees and bush or shrubs, and they help hold the soil down and act as a barricade to catch the soil that is being washed away. So they are acting as a barricade. That means they are the natural barricade or natural walls, and therefore they protect the soil, and therefore the natural barriers are necessary for avoiding the soil erosion. That is the first way. And the second way, they have barrier to catch water as it flows down the slope carrying the soil, and they keep the ground cover at all times to prevent the water washing the soil away. And therefore, either by the perennial plants or we are constructing the barriers, and therefore either way that we can avoid the soil erosion. Now let us talk about the wind erosion. See, it occurs after prolonged drought, the same logic, and little remaining root structures to hold the soil, and there is no much organic matter in soil to act as a sponge to any residual moisture, because the soil is acting as a sponge also. See, for example, you take the sponge, see, when there is moisture, then what will happen? This will absorb some small amount of moisture, and therefore the topsoil that is acting as a sponge. Then when there is no organic matter there, only the sand particles are there, then the sponge effect is missing there, and therefore the residual moisture that is missing, and so naturally what will happen? So when the wind is blowing, because when the moisture is there, that is binding the soil. If there is no moisture, there is no binding force, and therefore what will happen? When the wind is blowing, the topsoil that is eroded or it is blown away. And so, what are the solution? See, by growing the perennial plant, trees, shrubs and all, and they prevent the wind whipping it away, and they improve the ability of the soil to retain moisture, so it less easily blown away by measures including adding organic matter. See, here there is a small bush. See, what is the velocity? And the top velocity, that is 48 kilometer per hour. That means the wind is blowing at a speed of 48 kilometer per hour. But when it is reaching the bottom, it is acting as a barrier. And so the wind speed that has already come down 33 kilometer per hour. And the top one that is flowing without any barrier or without any stop. But the bottom side, it has to go through the bush, and therefore the velocity has come down from 33 kilometer per hour to 16 kilometer per hour, and therefore what will happen? The houses, they are protected from the wind, and therefore this is called the shelter belts of plants, and therefore plants, they are protecting us. Otherwise what will happen? If the wind is blowing at 48 kilometer per hour, that means severe damage will happen for the construction or the house also, and therefore it is a major effect of the bushes or the shrubs. And next, the climate, how it is affecting the desertification. See, again, drought, it is resulting in low rainfall, and so the soils become dry, and there is no water left in wells also, and the trees die, the grass withers and is replaced by poor desert shrubs, and therefore what will happen? The crops fail, and cattle feed on poor pasture, and less roots to protect the topsoil, less humus, and so the soils become more sandy and dry. And the wind erosion is removing the soil, causing dust storms and leaving bare rock. And so the climate also is affecting, or it is also leading to desertification. And the human activity, the demand increases for water as the population grows, and the trees are cut down for fuel supplies, and we call it as deforestation. And less vegetation, bare soil, and more wind erosion. See, to increase the food supplies, more crops are grown and more cattle kept, leading to over cultivation and over grazing. Therefore, when the population is increasing, the over cultivation and over grazing both are happening simultaneously, and therefore the yield is declining and the cattle are undernourished and die, and therefore even though the cultivation and grazing is increased, then also the same result happens. See, the estimates of percentage of human action, the overgrazing is amounting to 35%, the deforestation 30%, the other agricultural activities 28%, and the overexploitation of fuel wood and the bio-industrial activities for 1%. That means, out of all the activities, the overgrazing is the major activity corresponding for the desertification, and therefore if we are reducing the overgrazing and the deforestation, then at least that some 65% of the desertification that we can avoid. And some long term solution, fencing the areas to prevent the animal grazing, because if there is no fence, the animal, they are going to all the places and therefore they destroy all the lands. And introducing the drought resistant crops, for example the millet, because they are able to sustain grow even in very adverse conditions also. And planting the trees and bushes to provide cover for soil and stop it being blown or washed away. And rotating the crops and water them using irrigation technique, because there is a number of irrigation technique, because simply flowing the water is not the only irrigation type, because there are drip irrigation, drop irrigation, and some other kinds of irrigations are also there. And therefore we have to rotate the crops, and we have to change the irrigation method also. And building the stone wall, as we have already seen, the barriers that we have to construct, the building stone walls to collect the moisture. And another thing, by that is covering the sand dune, because that we can stabilize the sand dune by growing some thorny bush. Suppose if the thorny bush is not there, what will happen? The sand that is blown away, and because of that, that is protecting the sand dunes. And therefore by that way that we can stabilize the sand dunes also. And by managing the waste lands, because instead of keeping a land as barren, that we can have some bush or shrubs or some agricultural activities, so that we can utilize the waste lands, manage in a better way. And afforestation, it is totally opposite to deforestation. By the putting the saplings or by growing the trees and all, and therefore that is also avoid the grazing to certain extent. And some more solution, improving the water supplies by building large reservoirs and drilling deeper wells, and conserve water in local small scale schemes. For example, in Tamil Nadu, the water harvesting, because in every house, when the rainwater is flowing, that is automatically going into the gutters, and ultimately that is reaching the ocean. And instead of that, keeping the water in the same place, that means by conserving water in local small scale schemes, and the water harvesting is one such schemes, and encouraging the sustainable farming practices, and providing drought resistant seed and tree planting schemes, and international action to reduce the causes of global warming, all these can be long term solutions. Now let us summarize. In this episode, we have discussed the factors affecting desertification, the effects of drought, overgrazing, over cultivation and cutting of trees, soil erosion and wind erosion, the impact of human activity on soil degradation, and some steps to avoid land degradation have been discussed in detail. Now let us ask some questions. Mention 4 major factors of soil degradation. And second question, write the impact of overgrazing on soil degradation. And third, how sand dunes stop soil erosion. And the fourth one, does overcultivation affect the soil salinity? If so, how does it affect? And the last question, mention some solutions for protecting the soil environment. Dear viewers, so far we have discussed how the land is becoming a desert, and we have discussed everything in detail. And now that we conclude the episode, thank you.